Transnistria is home to one of the so-called frozen conflicts of the former Soviet Union. In 1990, the mainly Russian-speaking region broke away from what was then Soviet Moldova. That set the stage for a bloody conflict in 1992 between pro-Russian separatists and Moldovan forces, which ended in a Russian-brokered ceasefire. Today, Transnistria has its own army, as well as its own constitution, currency and flag. But it's not recognised by the international community. And tensions there are rising. Authorities say explosions have hit radio masts and the State Security Service headquarters in the space of a day. That's put Moldovan leaders on edge.
E o situație complexă și tensionată. Noi suntem vigilenți. Vom lua toate măsurile necesare pentru prevenirea unor escaladări.
So, how does this all fit in with Ukraine? Well, if Russia achieves its stated aim of taking full control of the south, that would open a clear corridor to Transnistria. Military experts are divided on whether Russia can achieve that, but it's already causing apprehension in the enclave, with some heading west into other parts of Moldova. And fueling those concerns are comments from a senior Russian commander who says there is evidence that the Russian-speaking population in Transnistria is being oppressed. That rings alarm bells because a similar pretext was used as the Kremlin's justification for invading eastern Ukraine.
They're preparing the ground for it. For the Russian audience, preparing the ground that they're... Transnistria is under threat, it needs to be basically defended in the same way that we had the narrative about Donbass and genocide there and the instability, and it needed to be defended and Moldova could be next.